Hey guys, hope you're doing great. We are on video number two of this series, Bible Meditations. Last video we covered James 2:26, and today we're going to cover a new passage. But I just want to reiterate the purpose of this series is to look over or be presented with new passages of scripture in the Bible that we can memorize and meditate upon, and then hopefully be able to apply at some point in our lives. And I hope you guys take these verses, you mark them down, whether that be in your journal, your devotional journal, or whether that be marking it down, highlighting it in your Bible. And I just encourage you guys, like with today's passage, when we bring it forward, don't just memorize it today and feel like, all right, I got it memorized, but maybe watch the video again. Maybe meditate upon that scripture. Try to at least do it once each and every day. You could do it right alongside with your Bible devotions, with being daily in the Word. And the goal is to hide it within your heart. Like Psalm 119 says, verse 11, "Thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee." Now, all these different passages of scriptures can serve different purposes, can be applied to different facets of our lives. It could be a verse that could help us when we are faced with temptation. It could be a verse that could strengthen us when we're in the midst of a trial. Or it could be a verse like today's that reminds us of our purpose, why we're here on earth. What is our goal? What are we supposed to do for Christ? And if you can't guess, today's verse is Matthew 5:16. It's behind me on this mural we have in my teen class for the Lighthouse teens. It says Matthew 5:16, "Be a light." And that's the goal of a Christian, is to be a light unto the world. If you want it right now, it's Matthew 5:16, "Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven." Think of that. It's kind of interesting to sound that others see you, but glorify someone they don't see. Glorify God. And that's the purpose for us here on earth as Christians, to be a light, to be a testimony unto others around us. This verse, Matthew 5:16, is actually found in the context, in a passage in Matthew 5, when Christ is likening believers unto salt and light. These things that are to stand out, they're to draw other men unto it, that they can be a witness and a testimony unto them. So this verse serves a couple of purposes. One, it reminds us of what our purpose is here on earth, to be a witness, to be in everything we do, glorify God, that others, when seeing what we do and how we act and what we say, don't just see us specifically, but they think, you know what, there's something different about Bobby or Susie or, you know, whatever your name is. There's something different about them, and they inquire and they want to learn more, and they find out about your relationship with Jesus Christ. And you say, you know what, maybe there is something about this whole Christian thing. Maybe there is something about this whole following Christ, and they want to learn more, and then they begin to glorify your Father which is in heaven. It's not about us receiving glory, and sadly that happens a lot of times with Christians, especially teenagers or people who grow up in church. We get kind of into a rut. We get kind of into a groove, so to speak, in which we know how to act like a Christian, how to look good, play good, you know, smell good, whatever the saying is. We know how to put on the facade of what it means to be a Christian, but we don't truly mean it in our lives. And people can see through that. People can see if you're being disingenuous. And a lot of people are turned off to Christianity because of hypocrites, what they claim to be hypocrites they saw earlier in their life. And let this verse be an encouragement to you that, guys, when you live the Christian life, when you're seeking to glorify God, it's not for your glory, it's that others in seeing you can glorify your Father which is in heaven. Matthew 5:16, once again, "Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven." Think of that. We are to be a light. The way we live, our testimony is to be a light in this dark and evil world, in this dark and wicked world. You don't have to think hard. You just have to turn the news on at some point during your day, and you'll be flooded with just bad news, all right? Violence happening in the world, these different philosophies that are opposed to Christ and his word just being flooded and trying to indoctrinate people in sin. There's a lot of evil. There's a lot of darkness in this world. And when people see true light, when they see someone who is truly faithfully seeking to glorify God and serve them with their lives, it stands out to them. And I pray that's your guys' desire and prayer each and every day of your life, is to be a light for the world, to be that salt and light that you can draw men, not to you, but draw men, those who are lost, those who are living in sin and without a Savior, draw men to your Father. Draw men to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. And that's what this verse is all about, shining your light that you can be a witness, a testimony unto others, but not for your glory. Not that other people are going to say, hey, Bobby, he's a great Christian, or Susie, she's a really upstanding gal. No, it's so that others seeing you will glorify your Father in heaven and come to know him as their Savior. Once again, we'll finish the video with that verse. It's Matthew 5:16. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Guys, it's not about you. It's about Christ. And that should sum up everything we do in this life. That should remind you, let it remind you of what your purpose is here on earth. It is to be a light unto the lost and to draw them unto Christ, to draw them unto Christ and to glorify your Savior. I hope you guys take this verse, try to memorize it. If you have memorized already, that's great. Meditate upon it. Bring it back up within your day throughout the next week or so when we get the next video out in this series. And if anything, at least mark it down in your Bible, guys. Bible meditations means to chew upon, to always bring back up in your mind. So as we leave this day, don't just memorize the verse once and forget about it. Memorize it and recall it day after day after day. I'm not saying you guys have to fill your entire day with always saying Matthew 5:16, but at least once a day. That's my challenge for you guys right now. Once a day, try to recite this passage again. Like, say if you memorize it today and you try to say it tomorrow and you don't quite have it memorized all the way, open your Bible back up, look it over, memorize it again. Maybe watch this video again to remember the purpose of this verse and how you can apply it to your life. And then do the same thing the day after. And the day after that, meditate upon his word that you can hide it within your heart and be able to apply it in the future at some point to remind yourself why you're here on earth, what your purpose is. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you're doing great. Like I said, this is a series that's not going to happen every day. It's going to be every 1 to 2 weeks. I think this is 2 weeks now from the first video. And I hope it's something that you guys enjoy, and I hope it's something that you take to heart. You don't even have to stay with just this verse. If you feel like, you know what, I got this verse down. If you came across a verse in your Bible through your daily in the Word or through your devotions, pick a verse through that to memorize as well and apply as just all the same. Hope you guys are doing great. Stay safe. Stay healthy. God bless.